Hello friends, today we will take the problems based on proving that a given number is irrational. So let's start with this new topic today. No doubt in this topic, students are facing lots of problems because it is a new thing for you and everything which is new, it is hard to understand. Every time to deal with the difficult part of the syllabus, you have to take care the points which are new for you. And for this, you have to make some mapping. Through mapping, we will take only two steps and the complete exercise will be easy for you. Let's start with the first step. Let's start first understand the first step which we'll use in this exercise. I have on the screen some prime numbers and their square number also. If a number is divisible by the square number, so no doubt that number is divisible by that particular number also. For example, here 4 is divisible by 2 and 2 is also divisible by 2. If 9 is divisible by 3, so 3 is also divisible by 3 and so on. You can watch it carefully and understand the concept properly first of all. The same concept is given in theorem 1.3 in a higher level. Maine wahi baat aapko simply samjhai and it is written in P and A form. And it is clear to us that if there is a number P and P divides A square, then P divides A also, where A is a positive integer. Now we will take the question and we have to prove that root 2 is irrational. Whatsoever we have learned earlier, we use that ingredient here to solve this theorem or to prove this theorem. First of all, we are having root 2 and I have to prove that it is irrational. For that, I have to take care of a new method which is contradictory method. In this contradictory method, we have to take the given statement false and then by contradiction we have to prove it. How? So let's start. First of all, we will assume the contrary that root 2 is rational. Proof kya karna hai? That it is irrational, but we will take the false statement that is it is irrational. So, we can find integer r and s such that root 2 is equals to rs. We know that hum rational number kabhi bhi prove kar sakte hain, so we always have p upon q and q is not equal to 0. So, that is the same thing and here I am taking rs, but I know that r and s should be common factor, not a common factor rather than 1. So, after cutting it and make the common factor 1 only, I have to change and it will become AB. You can skip these two lines also. And let's start with root 2 is equals to A by B. We know that A by B should be co-prime and B should not be equal to 0. When you cross multiply it, it will become B root 2 is equals to A. Now, I have to square both the sides. After squaring it, we know that root 2 will become 2. And B will become B square and A will become A square. When you stop yourself here, you can write down that 2 divides A square. How is it? It is written that 2B square is equal to A square and B square should be equal to A square upon 2. So whatsoever the value we get of B square, it is after dividing A square by 2. So I can write down that 2 divides A square. And as the ingredient I have prepared for you earlier from theorem 1.3, it is known to you that if 2 is divides A square, so 2 must be divide A also. Now these two steps you have to take very care. Here the new line is A is equals to 2C for some integer C. I'll let you explain this once again. I have given you that 2 divides A. For example, I am giving you that 6 divides by 2. So how the 6 come? The 6 factors are 2 into 3. When you multiply 2 with 3, so you can get 6. In the same manner, I have written because 2 divides A, it means A is equals to 2 into C. C means like here I have taken 2 into 3. So C can be an integer. So I can write down A is equals to 2C. Let's start with the next page. Now we replace 2b square is equal to a square by this new value that a is equal to 2c. By replacing it, it will become 2b square is equal to 4c. and when you cut 2 and 4 together, so the statement will become b square is equals to 2c square. Now again, this means that 2 divides b square. Actually, this is the same point which we have done with a square. Now we will say use the same point with b square. It means that 2 divides b square. Kaise? That if I'll take 2c square ka 2 in the denominator of b square, so it should be equal to c square. So getting the value of c square, I should be able to divide b square by 2. So the same steps we will repeat with b square. This means that 2 divides b square, and as theorem 1.2, it means that 2 divides b also. And here I can conclude with these two points together, that 2 is divisible by a in the previous page, and here 2 is divisible by b also. So there must be a common factor which is 2 here. But this is a contradiction. We have already given in our solution that a and b have no common factor other than 1. But here I can see that there is one more common factor which is 2 in this given calculation. So this is a contradiction. And why this contradiction arise? Because our incorrect assumption in the starting. So we can conclude that root 2 is irrational. So this is your final answer. Once again, I summarize it for you. First of all, if a prime number is divisible by a square, so that should be divisible by a also. And in the given theorem, you have to show that 2 is a common factor between a and b both. After repeating twice or thrice this theorem, it is very easy to understand the next concept of this exercise. I hope so you understand this theorem very well, and it will definitely help you to solve the next question. Let's start. For better understanding, I am taking 3 questions simultaneously, and it will enhance your understanding. Let's take the first one. I have written these 3 questions, and you can find out the basic steps. Here, root 2 is a rational number, and exists positive integer a and b, and root 2 is equals to a by 2, where a and b are coprime, and 2 root 2 is equals to a. Now, the same steps I follow for root 3, and the same steps I repeat for root 5 also. Now the second step, in the second step we have to do squaring both the sides. B root 2 is equals to a ka square, it will become 2b square is equal to a square, and a square divides by 2. So theorem 1.3 used to show that a divided by 2 also, and we have also, and we can write that a is equal to 2c. Now the same process we will follow with root 3 as well as root 5, and we get a is equals to 3c, and for 5 we can get a is equals to 5c. Now the third step starts, that substituting for a we get 2b square is equal to 4c square, and this shows that b square divides by 2, and from theorem 1.3 b divides by 2. The same process we will follow for root 3 and root 5, and here we can get that b divides by 3 and b divides by 5. Now again the last step comes, that a and b both at least 2 as a common factor, as well as for root 3 and root 5 we have 3 and 5 as a common factor also. And now the contradiction lines will come, that this contradiction has arisen because of incorrect assumption, and we conclude with the answer that root 2, root 3 and root 5 is irrational. This comparison will be easy for you to understand. I hope you understand these 3 questions very well. Let's start with the next part. After getting the comparison of the 3, I have prepared the different slides of these 3 questions for you. First of all, you have to take AB which is coprime, then squaring both sides, then 5 is divisible by A, and then it is divisible by B also, and because 5 is common in both, so that is irrational number. Root 3 also separately I have done. Here again we will use the same method, A upon B equals to root 3, where A and B are co-prime, then squaring both sides, as well as A is divisible by 3 and B also. So this is not a co-prime number, and again root 3 is irrational. Now the difficult part of the exercises has been solved. Easiest part is coming now. 5 minus root 3 is irrational. For this type of question, again we will use the first step, that 5 minus root 3 is equals to a by b, where a and b are co-prime numbers. And here, when you take root 3 to the other side by transposing, it will become 5 minus ab equals to root 3. By rearranging the equation and taking the LCM, we are having 5b minus a upon b. And we know that 5 minus a upon b is rational and root 3 is irrational, that we have already proved. It means again there is a incorrect assumption that 5 minus root 3 is rational. So we can conclude that 5 minus root 3 is irrational. The same process we will follow with 3 root 2. Here also we will put 3 root 2 equals to a upon b. Again you have to leave root number in LHS or RHS. So you will leave only root 2 and take 3 from that side and transpose it, and it will become a upon 3b. Again 3, a and b are integers. So a upon 3b is rational and root 2 is rational. It is a contradiction because we have already proved that root 2 is irrational. So we conclude that 3 root 2 is irrational. Some more question like this. 3 plus 2 root 5. Again you have to keep it in P by Q or A by B. You can take any number where Q is not equals to 0. Again you have to keep only root number in particular side and transpose all the thing which is on the next side. Like here, I first of all take 3 and after transposing it will become minus 3, and because 2 is multiplied with root 5 and you can transpose 2 and it will be in denominator, and my RHS will become P minus 3Q upon 2Q, and root 5 is on the left hand side. Now we know that P and Q are integer, therefore P minus 3Q and 3Q are also integer. His RHS of the equation is a rational number, where LHS, that is root 5, is an irrational number. Again we get that contradiction. Hence our assumption is 3 plus root 5, a rational number, is wrong. And by contradiction we again prove that 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational. Let's take some more examples. Now we have to show that 1 upon root 2 is a irrational one. So again I have to put it with a is equal a upon b, where a and b are co-prime and b is not equal to 0. Again you have to keep root 2 in separate side and b by a in separate side. Here I have done the cross multiplication so that root 2 will be numerator. Now root 2 is equals to b upon a, and we know that b upon a is rational, and so root 2 is rational. Aisa kyun? Because b by a rational hai and it is equal to root 2, so definitely it should also be rational. But we have already proved that root 2 is irrational, so again there is a contradiction arise because we already assumed wrong. So last we can conclude that root 2 is irrational. Let's take 7 root 5. Again let us assume that 7 root 5 is rational. Again you have to take co-prime integer a and b, where b is not equal to 0, and again you have to keep root 5 alone by picking 7 and put it 7 in denominator. A upon 7b is rational, and it means it is equal to root 5, so that means root 5 is also rational. But this is a contradiction because we have already know that root 5 is irrational, and this contradiction has arisen because of our wrong assumption. So we can conclude that 7 root 5 is irrational. In all the question, the same steps are following. That's why at the end you can find again and again repeating the same step, and it is easy to you to understand. Last but not the least, let us assume that 6 plus root 2 is rational. Again, you have to take only root 2 alone and keep 6 by transposing in the right hand side, and a upon b minus 6, it should be equals to root 2. Since a and b are integers, we get a upon b minus 6 is rational. So root 2 is also rational, but this is contradiction because we know that root 2 is irrational. This contradiction has arisen because of incorrect assumption. So we can conclude that 6 plus root 2 is irrational. Thank you for watching, and like, share and subscribe for more videos.